I would start by talking about our team's commitment to upholding our baseline expectations being a huge reason why, you know, we had so much success tonight, in particular on the defensive end. Although we beat Detroit on Saturday, a really tough, talented Detroit team, we just didn't do the job at all defensively. There were spurts where we did some really good things. You know, we barely out-rebounded them. And Sunday was off, Monday morning, 7 a.m. film session. I really got after those guys because I didn't appreciate how we guarded and how we rebounded. And I told them, going forward, if that was going to be the standard, then we were going to have a tough time. And I challenged them on practice on Monday, practice on Tuesday. Our staff challenged them. And on Wednesday, yesterday, here in the Bahamas, I thought we had our best practice of the year. And that led into us playing really well tonight. You know, that's how we got to defend and rebound every night.
We'll open it up for questions. Just go ahead and have at it.
Hey, Mike, you guys, even when you've played some pretty good first shot defense this year, you haven't always been great finishing those possessions with rebounds. Mississippi State, obviously a very big team, good rebounding team. What do you think about the way you guys were handling the boards there tonight?
Yeah, I thought it was phenomenal. You know, we finally rebounded the ball like Louisville basketball is supposed to rebound the ball. We all rebound a big, athletic Mississippi State team that has a chance to contend for SEC championship by 47-38. We get 15 offensive rebounds. We did the job. It was great to see.
Mike, you talked about Wednesday's practice being one of the best of the season. Do you think, you know, what went into that, guys on the road, or maybe they're just fed up from Sunday, or a little of everything?
Yeah, you know what? I think it's because I let them go to the water park on Wednesday morning. You know, sometimes I can be a pretty hard guy, and I felt like it was a no-brainer that we had to let these guys breathe a little bit. You know, I leaned on them pretty good in the days leading up to it, and it just worked out scheduling-wise that after breakfast on Wednesday, we had breakfast at 10. I want to say from 10:30 to almost 2:30, those guys were allowed to have some downtime. And I think it was good and refreshing for everybody to kind of get away. I even went down the slide myself. And it was exhilarating, and it was good. And Kenny Klein filmed it, and nobody else will see it but me. But we got away for 4 hours, and the guys were happy. And I think that everybody kind of decompressed, and thankfully so, because we came out and played really hard and really well today.
These are early season games, but this is a pressure situation for all of you. I mean, you didn't expect to be doing this and them and all that. I mean, is that just that little release maybe enough to kind of get you back straight a little bit, or them?
Yeah, I mean, I hear you when you say pressure. I get it, you know, but this is what we do for a living, you know. And I know that they're kids. I've never been a head coach before until now, so we all got, you know, kind of thrown into something, and we got dealt a hand, and we got to play the hand. And it's basketball. These guys have been playing basketball for a long time. Although I'm not a head coach, I've been around the game for a long time, and we all had to adapt and adjust and move on. And you know, pressure has to make us better, not make us shaky. And I thought that we answered the bell today.
Coach Michael McCammon, Cardinal Authority. The team came out, and even though the offense wasn't really clicking initially, it seemed like the defense really pushed the matter early. I've just talked about how they came out focused on their defensive end to start this game.
Yeah, like I said, you know, we challenged those guys. I challenged them personally. Our staff did, you know, long film session on Monday morning. You know, I mean, I literally talked for an hour about defense and rebounding alone. And it carried over into our practice. We had a really competitive practice on Monday. Although we weren't perfect, it was spirited, it was competitive. Tuesday was a really good practice. The practices just got better. And if you practice well, you get a chance to play well. You know, there's really no magic formula to this thing. Keep the ball in front, keep it out of the lane, you know who their best players are and take what they want to do well away. And when the shot goes up, find somebody to hit and rebound the ball.
Hey, Mike, after you guys lost to Furman, you talked about challenging them in practice, and they responded and played really well against Navy. You don't have your best performance against Detroit. You challenge them again. What does it take maybe to get those guys now to not need to, like, to handle success and not need that extra push from you guys?
That's a great question. That's $1 million question there. If I knew that one, boy, I'd be all over that one. I would like to think that our older guys, in fact, everybody to a man, I would like to think realizes, man, Coach Mike might be on to something. You know, our staff is on to something. if we really, really and truly, genuinely commit to guarding and keeping the ball in front and challenging shots and executing the scouting report on the defensive end, everybody taking a defensive approach before they think anything about their offense, if we truly commit to that and cleaning it up with a defensive rebound, we can beat anybody. That's been our message from day one. Now, we had to take the entire summer to infuse our new offense. And I think that although it was much needed, it did not allow us to really embrace who we needed to be on the defensive end. And I think we're just getting caught up to that. And hopefully that will continue, and it'll be a snowball effect defensively and on the glass. And if that's the case, you know, I like our chances against anybody.
Coach, is Dre Davis one of those guys? I mean, he had a couple nice defensive plays, but was getting after on both sides of the floor. And obviously after a difficult, start to the season, he's really come on in the last two games. Just how have you seen him progress and not allow those slow starts to get, creep into his mind?
Dre's a solid individual, and I said before, nobody is harder on Dre than Dre Davis. Despite all of the comments that you see in social media about him not needing to start and he can't do this and do that, nobody's harder on Dre Davis than Dre Davis. And sometimes that's a curse. A lot of times that's a curse because he gets so down on himself. He has so much value beyond what he does from the three-point line. He made two big threes tonight. He goes 2-for-5. That's great. But his effort on the defensive end, guarding multiple guys, guarding Jeffries, who I think has a chance to be a pro, guarding even Molinar, who again is probably a pro. He has defensive versatility. He sticks his nose in. He's a coach's son. He knows how to play the game the right way. And he adds so much value to our team beyond his three-point shooting. And I never want him to forget that because he's an integral part of what we do and what we need as a team.
Take one more for Coach, and then we're going to go to Sam.
Mike, you guys, as always, played a lot of guys, and a lot of guys spread the minutes around. You hope that maybe helps you a little bit with a pretty short turnaround here.
Yeah, it's good to have depth, especially on a one-day turnaround. We're going to play a tough Maryland team. I don't think Maryland plays a ton of guys, not as many as we do. We didn't have one guy play over 30 minutes, so hopefully we're fresh and excited about getting an opportunity to win our first championship in a while.
Thanks, Coach.
Thank you. Sam, it's all yours.